We're here in northern Manhattan in the communities that we serve as part of the medical center. We're conducting a study of women who were enrolled in pregnancy, and we have followed them and their then newborns, now children. Some of the children, the oldest children, are 13 years old now. So this study has been going on a long time. We follow them in time in order to better understand the role of very early exposures, those occurring in the womb and during the first months and years of life, the role of those exposures in childhood developmental problems and also in diseases like asthma, in obesity, metabolic disorders, and other disorders, diseases of childhood. The research worker goes to the home, does an extensive interview.
Has your child spent a total of 1 month or more outside of northern Manhattan?
Another research worker who goes with her provides a backpack monitor to the woman. It's a small personal monitor. It's light, it's pretty quiet, and it is worn during, like a regular backpack, and carried on back during the day. When women are walking around, when they're sitting, and when they're in bed, they keep it with them. And this is collecting a continuous air sample. Now, the air is collected at the breathing zone, this being a personal air monitor, and the air comes through, is drawn by a pump through several filters where the gases and the particles are deposited. In addition to the air monitoring, personal air monitoring, monitoring is done in the homes of the families participating.
Well, you do have a cat.
So with all this information of repeated monitoring, air monitoring, we have some very interesting results. No surprise, stressors associated with poverty are worsening the effects of environmental contaminants. All this is coming around to telling us that we have vulnerable populations and we have vulnerable babies, even starting during the fetal period in childhood. And we really need to do more to protect them. They really are our future. And we hope that our research, which is shedding light on the role of preventable risk factors, can really make a difference in children's lives and in their futures.